your friends, you wiggles.
Are you gone?
Right, that was a preview of the Goonies Custom Arcade Build. Now then, this is a new designed Goonies Custom Arcade Build by Sharkade. This is a slight different variant. Now we have a nice wood finish on the center art of this unit. We have a ton of gold trim on there with the buttons as well, which are a high quality gold trim LED buttons with the gold ball tops as well. This unit is a slightly taller unit than our standard 27 inch builds, so I'll go through that in a moment and explain that as well, and I'll show off something cool on the back also, which just looks really, really smart, really touches up this unit. Now I'm gonna start getting a collection together because we have done so many cool builds, but there is a few cool builds out there that stand out more than the rest of Sharkade builds. Now that's gonna go into a collection of a Master Class collection, and then we'll be on certain special offers with the extra bits and pieces, like the gold ball tops and stuff like that, and the gold trim buttons, which are all extra cost. Then we'll go into a special offer and everything. So yeah, so on the front of the unit we do have a mini amp. These mini amps have MP3 playback, they also have radio, and they have a USB port, a SD card port, so you can just place MP3 straight on to an SD card or a USB memory stick. We also have RGB LEDs in this unit, and they're also sound activated, so you can change the different modes with the controller provided. You also have a control for the mini amp. Now if you wanted to play a bit of music, you can just go and do the tidying up and just swap and change the tracks while carrying the motor around with you. Also comes with a wireless keyboard and mouse. Now these wireless keyboard and mouses can be a little fiddly because they're small, but other than that they're perfect for doing little bits and pieces. If there's any config issues or anything like that we need to sort out, or any keyboard systems that require a keyboard, and so that's available. This unit also comes with two Xbox 360 controllers. The customer didn't order the Wii controller kit with this build, so I'll not show that off. I can't show that off. So yeah, on the system there's around 98,000 games. Thousands and thousands of MAME, Mega Drive, Super Nintendo, Game Boy, Atari, PlayStation 1, 2, 3, and some cool next-gen titles like Tekken 7, Street Fighter 5, Mortal Kombat XL, and Dragon Ball FighterZ, and a lot more. So the hardware in these aren't just your standard low-end builds. They're quite a decent PC in just our standard builds, which you're getting a Ryzen 3 chipset with 8 gig of DDR4 RAM. So you've got the more next-gen RAM in there rather than the older DDR3, which a lot of arcade builders and companies use these old Dell machines and stuff, or they don't put very good hardware inside them. You have a GTX 1650 graphics card in this machine, and we have our 8 terabyte Hyperspin build. So yeah, nice little bit of hardware. We do offer higher end systems as well. So we do a Ryzen 5 build with 16 gig of DDR4 RAM with an RTX 2060 graphics card. That's usually for our 11 terabyte and our 16 terabyte Hyperspin builds, because there's a ton of next gen PC titles on there what require the bit better hardware. So we also do offer a deluxe control panel. So if you're not, if you don't have a lot of room in your home, but you want the really high-end experience of gaming and stuff as well, we offer a 16 terabyte build for 2,500. But that's a two-player arcade stick that'll plug into your TV or your gaming monitor, and it's quite transportable. But I'll leave a link below in the description showing off one of those units. Those units are quite powerful as well. I believe they're a bit more powerful than my higher end builds, because it requires a small form factor motherboard. So it requires a different form factor of Ryzen 5 CPU. So the Ryzen 5 CPU in that, I believe, is a 3600 rather than the 2600 we use. It does have the 16 gig of DDR4 RAM, but we also offer in those units as well an RTX 3060 graphics card, which is absolutely ridiculous when it comes to high-end gaming. Really, really good high-end GPU, and for the games and everything that's on this system, plus the 16 terabyte build, it just finishes it off nicely, and you can have hours and hours of fun. So what I'll do is I'll cut away the video and then I'll show off the artwork. Right, so we'll start on the left hand side of the unit. Now around the whole side panel we do have this nice orange gold looking trim, and then we have that pure gold looking trim T-molding. Then we have the most highest quality possible artwork on the sides, and we only print the highest quality artwork. If the image is too low quality when it's getting designed, we'll not print it. I'll recommend other images, I'll design something else. On our artwork as well, you'll not find any bubbling, not like Extreme Home Crap Arcades. We actually use laminated MDF wood, and we don't just stop there. We actually use a moisture resistant MDF, which comes in like a greeny color, and it's a bit more of a HDF, high density fiber board. So it's a bit tougher than standard MDF. It's a bit stronger, a bit more durable. Like I say, we use it laminated, so when the artwork sticks on, it stays on, and it shows in the units. You've got to have a nice clean perfect surface. If you're painting stuff like MDF and you're not treating it properly, it shows, and it does show on other cabinet builders. So that's why we only use melamine MDF, but we actually get the higher grade stuff as well. Most companies, if they do melamine MDF, they just get the standard MDF board. So like I say, we have down the side that lovely looking artwork. Then across the control panel there, we have a nice image with all the Goonies there. And then we have One-Eyed Willy in the middle there with these beautiful looking One-Eyed Willy's key there, custom dust covers. And we've also, for the customer, printed a reverse dust cover as well. So you've got a glossy one there, a set of glossy ones. ready for the customer if he wishes to swap them out. These we have all those yellow gold buttons as well, so the gold trim around the edge of the buttons, and then we have those nice gold ball tops. So I've given the customer those, I had some lying around, so I've let him have those, which I've got to say look just really smart on this unit. All the gold look, and the wood effect just stands right out. So across the center panel there, the front panel, we have that nice old rustic wood effect, and some more gold T-mold in there in the center and those gold buttons. But actually, if you look, if you can see slightly, it's got all the Goonies map actually imposed on the wood itself. So it's got tons of little bits of detail in off the Goonies map and stuff, and it just looks really nice on there. It just stands out nicely. From a distance you can't see it. When you get close, you see all the nice little bits of detail in there. Throughout the center, we have built this unit a little taller, so this is more of a 32 inch size. So we've got a nice thick bezel going around the screen there with that nice dark wood effect. And then underneath the marquee, we have Never See It Die, which is a nice little Easter egg to the Goonies there. And then all that gold tea molding down the side there. Then up on the marquee, we have those RGB LEDs fading in and out. It's on slow fade at the moment, so it's looking quite orange. And then we have that nice skull there, which looks smart on there. All the different wood and rocks behind, and those gold doubloons. Are they called gold doubloons? Gold coins, all there on each side. Looks more like a treasure chest look, this unit. And then if we move over to the right hand side, we have that artwork repeated there with the Goonies logo just reversed, which looks beautiful, man. Now coming round, probably my favorite part of the unit is these custom grills, and I'll show off something else in a second, but we'll have that nice wood effect, which this, it actually looks like wood. It looks like it's made from wood, but it's just printed. And it looks so clean and smart on there. It's all cut in nicely. All the trim and that is wrapped in it as well. And it just matches up really nice. I think that artwork matches up with that artwork there as well. And there's a bit of map, and that's a bit of blood, I think, that was on the map. So it looks actually like stained blood on the wood. And then you have that one-eyed Willy's key there with that nice design on the outside. And then over here, we have not just a marquee on the front, we have a marquee on the back. Now, when I was doing this unit, I wanted a bit thicker trim on it, but I realized we didn't have a large enough back. So what I've done is I've added a more of a standard marquee with the two pieces of acrylic there and the display film sandwiched in between. And then we've just got that nice marquee look there. And we've Never See It Die instead of the Goonies on there, on the back. And then all the way through the back there, we have those USB ports as well on there. And then we have that Goonies custom grill on the back there, with that nice dark looking wood effect. And I believe this has got the whole map on there faded in the background, so you'd have to get in quite close and look at all the different bits of detail and stuff the right in on there, which is a perfect little touch to the unit itself. And I've got to say, I really, really like that back marquee. It stands out really nicely and breaks up just all the wood effect as well. Looking really cool. So then, if you wish to order a unit like this, it's likely I'll not be doing a back marquee on the next unit. I can, but I'll likely charge quite a bit for that, because acrylic ain't cheap at the moment. That was just spare bits of acrylic I had, but acrylic isn't cheap at the moment, so it's likely going to cost the price of a sheet, because by the time I use that material, I won't use the other material on anything else other than the grills. So yeah, if you wish to order a unit like this, contact us at dean@sharkade.com. I'll also, once I've uploaded the video, I'll create a sale page of the Goonies cabinet on my website, and then I'll have the different price options between 3 terabyte, 8 terabyte, 11 terabyte and 16 terabyte, and I'll have the different sizes, which will be 24 inch, 27 inch and 32 inch unit. So make sure you like, share and subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye. Please note also, if you wish to make a purchase for the Christmas time, please let us know and get your order in soon as possible, because we do have a large flux of orders come in around this time, and I won't be working over the Christmas period. I do have time off Christmas time, so it's best to just get your order in. It's first come, first served. If the units aren't fulfilled within the 8 weeks because of a large amount of orders come in, your order may be delayed till after the Christmas. So it's just best to get your order in straight away. We still have some openings to get units done by then. So it's best to just get your order in straight away, or you'll be waiting till after the Christmas itself. So I'll see you later. Bye.